up in my bones. You're the one that I desire. You're the all-consuming fire in your presence. When I'm at your throne, it's like fire. Shut up in my bones. You're the one that I desire. You're the all-consuming fire.
Fights for me, even death is swallowed up in victory because you are holy. of your glory.
I hear the sound of the angels gathered round, crying holy. I see the elders bowing down, casting all of their crowns down at your feet.
In this place right now, being built in this service right now. Big things happen in the fire of the Holy Ghost. We're going to sing it again. Let me tell you something real fast that I felt. Let me give you an illustration about what's happening. It has to do with my cooking of the day. I like my butter lukewarm. I don't like it cold. It won't spread on the bread. I don't like it hot because then you can't spread it because it's melted. I like my butter lukewarm. And what I do is, when I'm cooking on the stove, I set it beside the fire. Because beside the fire is warm enough, but not too hot. And every church service has pockets of fire. And you've got people by you that you feel some heat coming off of them. But you don't want to be like them. You like feeling the fire because it's not all the way in church. But it's enough to feel good to get you through the week. And I've been in this all my life, and there's pockets of fire, like a six-burner stove. There's pockets of praise and worship all over the house. But then there's always a few people sitting beside you. And they're not budging. And I'm going to tell you why it's dangerous to be in this church and come service after service without becoming like fire. Because he said, I will spew you out of my mouth if you stay lukewarm. Lukewarm is dangerous because it feels saved, but it has no effect of fire. It looks saved, but it's not saved. And I encourage you, don't just feel the glory of God, participate in the move of the Holy Ghost. If the people on fire are shouting, then start to shout. If the people on fire are lifting their hands, then lift your hands. Become the fire. The first time the Holy Ghost poured out, the Bible says it was like a fire, and it sat upon each of them. Every single person in the room became an independent burner for the power of the Holy Ghost. You know what I saw whenever I lifted your hands? I've got to do fires all the time in the backyard. Y'all look like a fire. Because as one person's hand goes up right here, another hand goes up over there, and it looks like the flickering of a fire in a church service. And I can see a fire. And as you begin to shout and begin to move, it dances back and forth. As the oxygen begins to move and the Spirit of God begins to flow, it's like a fire in the house. And you can feel it and you can see it. But I want that fire to be in me. I want that fire to consume me. It's not okay that it's somebody else. I want that fire to be inside of me. So sing it again, but lift up your hands and shout and dance and get involved in the Holy Ghost. Make contact with somebody. Grab a hold of somebody's hand and get what they've got inside of you. Come on, let's take 5 minutes and let's let the fire burn in this house right now.
Next to you and see, here it is, it's here, the home of Yeshua Messiah.